It was a busy day in the harbor. Thomas pulled in the harbor and picked up his two faithful coaches, Annie and Clarabelle. "It sure is a lovely day at the harbor," said Thomas. Then there was trouble. Salty was coming with a line of freight cars. Thomas tried to move, but his wheels were locked. Then he realized something. "Oh wait, the coach's wheels are locked. Not mine." And he uncoupled from the coaches and set off. The coaches, however, moved a little bit. Salty applied his brakes, but it was too late. Thomas soon brought Rocky to clean up the mess. Soon, Sir Tom Hack came. "Salty, I know this wasn't your fault, but another engine's going to have to fill in for you." "Yes, sir," said Salty. Thomas soon brought Salty some more. Spencer to fill in for Rocky. Salty. "I can't believe I have to go to the docks. All the smelly fish," said Spencer. Really, all he had to do was collect the engine's trucks. He saw Murdoch. "Can you bring me that train over there, please?" asked Murdoch. "Yes, Murdoch," said Spencer. Collected the train and brought it to Murdoch. Later, he saw James. "Can you fetch me Rocky over there? There's been an accident." Yes, James," said Spencer. Collected Rocky and brought it to James. "I think I'm doing a pretty good job," said Spencer. But what he didn't know is that Bill and Ben were hiding behind the trucks. They had been for the works and were finally repaired. Just then, Thomas came. "Can I have a train over there, please?" asked Thomas. "Sure," said Spencer. "Now," said Bill. When Spencer saw the train, he applied his brakes. "Are you okay?" asked Thomas.
"I think so," said Spencer, "but we're going to need Rocky."
"No worries, I'll get him," said Thomas. Soon, Thomas brought Rocky. Then Spencer was sent to the works by Thomas.